Strong skepticism expressed at the state capitol today about the safety of nuclear power plants, including Diablo Canyon. As KCRA3's political reporter Kevin Riggs explains, lawmakers rattled by that tragedy in Japan are looking at whether we need some stronger precautions.
The history of the Diablo Canyon nuclear power plant is filled with political potholes, and today was the latest as PG&E officials were summoned to the Capitol in the face of the Japan tragedy to defend the plant's safety.
I want to state that we're very proud of our operating history there. I believe we have large margins to safety.
PG&E's Steve David offered detailed assurances that the twin reactor, which is seeking license renewal from the federal government, has multiple backup systems in case of a catastrophic event. But those assurances were met with notable skepticism.
I do have some serious concerns.
Sam Blakesley's Senate district includes the Diablo Canyon plant. He sharply questions whether enough is known about coastal faults to allow for a truly safe design.
It's not surprising that sometimes we underestimate the potentiality of a fault system like we did in Japan.
Our reactors are in the most seismically active area of the world next to Japan, ours in California. And they appear to have been designed for earthquakes less than the faults are capable of nearby.
That uncertainty could lead to new, stricter oversight.
And if we continue to find out that the standards used in Japan may not have been adequate, we have to ask whether the standards used in California are adequate.
Kevin Riggs, KCRA 3 reports.
Diablo Canyon's licenses expire in 2024 and 2025. Today's hearing also focused on the state's other nuclear reactor, San Onofre, in San Diego County.